rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. To God be the glory for all the good things he's done in our lives. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Love you.
So let's go ahead and give us a prayer, Brother Jackson. I appreciate it if you don't mind. Hallelujah.
Okay. Let us pray. Dear God, worthy are you, dear Father. Thank you for who you are, what you are all about, all powerful, all knowing. You are love, dear Father. And we thank you that you loved us before we have learned how to love you.
Yes.
Lord, you know that 2020 was a challenging year. And you, for your divine reason and your divine purpose and your divine glory, have brought those of us who survived it into 2021.
Yes.
So therefore, Father, humbly acknowledge the fact that we are here for a purpose. We're here for a reason. We are here to worship you in our daily actions, in our daily thoughts, in our daily endeavors.
Yes.
Father, forgive us where we fail you. And we will probably fail you often, but we know that because of your mercy,
hallelujah,
you will help us, and you will be with us through trials, and you will be with us through tribulations, and irregardless as to what it may look like,
come on,
with our physical eyes, Lord, help us to keep our eyes on you, your spirit,
yes,
and what you are doing, because the victory is already won.
Come on now.
And we just thank you, dear Lord, for what you have already done. Lord, help us to help others. Help us to serve. We know that when we serve others, we serve you.
Yes.
And so let us do it gladly and joyfully. Let us be able to sacrifice where we need to sacrifice, not for our own accolades,
come on now,
but for your glory and for the glory of your son, Jesus. And Jesus, we thank you for the life that you lived. We thank you that you suffered. We thank you that you died for our sins.
Yes.
We thank you that God chose to raise you from the dead.
Yes.
So that those of us who believe in you,
yes,
have that,
yes,
spiritual blood that pouring out upon us.
Yes.
And that we are adopted into his family.
Yes.
And we just thank you that you are our Lord. You are our Savior, and you are our King.
Yes.
Teach us this morning. You know what you have ready for each one of us who will listen to this now live and who will listen to this in the future.
Woo!
And let it be nourishment to our spirits. And let us be able to do what you would have us to do. We say these things in Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Yes, sir. So that's a really good thing of pushing forward, is the kingdom of God is the push. Preaching the kingdom, the good news,
yes,
right? And
yes,
it's just living it. Part of the preaching is living it. And what I want to do is my favorite scripture that I love to read. And it's like, definitely got to always use it every year if I could. Anytime I come across it, I just love to read it. This is Isaiah 60, Brother Jackson. This is Isaiah 60, verse 1. Let me see. I'm going to go ahead and put even the camera over here just in case somebody may try to read it. But go ahead, brother. Read what it say. Read it. What the kingdom look like? Come on. Come on. Tell me something, brother.
Arise,
woo,
shine,
yes,
for thy light has come,
yes,
and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth,
yes, sir,
and gross darkness the people,
yes, sir,
but the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory,
yes,
shall be seen upon thee.
Woo!
Yes, and the Gentiles shall come to thy light,
yes,
and kings to the brightness of thy rising.
Come on now.
Lift up thine eyes round about and see.
Yes.
All they gather themselves together, they come to thee. Thy son shall come from afar,
yes, uh-huh,
and thy daughter shall be nursed at thy side.
Yes, sir.
Then shalt thou see and, woo, flow together, and thine hearts shall fear and be enlarged, because the abundance of the sea shall be converted unto thee.
Woo!
The force of the Gentiles shall come unto thee.
Amen, amen. Just to stop right there for a second. Just stop, just, okay, right there for a second. Is the fact is, you see, the fact is that's Jimmy. That's just like Chinatown. He said they will see it. All you have to do is rise and shine, right?
Amen.
For the light has come. The glory, huh? The glory has come. And
amen.
One of the things I was reading is the title there, y'all. You shall receive power and transform into his image. Transform.
Yeah.
transform into kingdom town, huh?
Amen.
they're gonna see it. The glory of the Lord, HM, there's that Chinatown. That's the glory of the Lord shall rise upon us. So that wherever we go, they'll see just like they're going, step into Chinatown, they come in your presence, they're stepping into the kingdom. And that's what he's asking us to do. Because we're Brother Jack, read that scripture down there, 2 Corinthians 4:4, and check that out.
Amen. In whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not.
Uh-huh.
Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them.
Oh, come on now. Come on, bro. Hey, Elder Johnson. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Happy 2021. Oh, he got his audio coming up. So we'll let him catch. I think he can hear us though while it's coming up. Maybe not. I guess not. Can you hear us, brother?
I can now. Yes. How you doing?
Hallelujah, sir. Hey, look, we got this concept. We're picking up a little bit from what we did last week. We talking about Chinatown, right? We're talking about Chinatown is in the United States, in a city, right? and you walk into it, you don't nobody need to tell you when you're into Chinatown. You start seeing the different things that constitute Chinatown, right?
Right.
Well, what we're saying is the scripture which we just read was Isaiah 60, verse 1-5, and then we just read 2 Corinthians 4, verse 4. And I'll show that to you real quick on that. Just show that to you. That's why I throw something.